made this dress, this long frock gown from a sari because the market was closed and I wanted to make something very urgent. Within 30-40 minutes, I wanted this long dress and I used a net sari and petticoat. I bought nothing to make this dress and I show you step by step how to do it so easy. First of all, you need to cut the bodies separately and skirt separately. So we cut the petticoat, we fold the petticoat and cut front and back of the bodies. See, the back neck is straight. I cut it straight. I gave it no shape. And from the outside, the outline is just like a normal kameez or a normal churidar suit. Here I mark the front armhole also, and this is the waistline. So just give it a shape. The front neck is 3 inch long and neck width is 3 inches because I am keeping it front open. Cut the front armhole and the neck. The front neck I will be keeping about 7 inches open, or you can keep it open till the waist length. Keeping this lining on the border of the sari, just cut 2 pieces that is open from the front. And when you place it on the lining, it will look something like this. The back side, I cut from the pallu of the sari itself. And there is no joint on the back side of the bodies. Here I got one collar neck from some old dress. So this is optional. If you have it, use. Otherwise, make new collars. To make the skirt, fold the petticoat and separate the belt from this. We don't want the belt. Now you fold the sari and keep the length plus 1/2 inch. Like the length I want for the skirt is 40 inches. I'm adding 1/2 inch to it and cutting it. We'll make a belt from this 3 inch wide cloth. It is long enough, like maybe double the waist round, so it will make a nice belt. Here I cut 2 sleeves keeping the pattern. If you want this pattern, please write me in the comment section. And I shared one pattern earlier also, so just keep the fabric and keep the pattern. Cut 2 sleeves. This is net sari, so these are very light short net sleeves. So here we cut the sleeves, but you can keep the sleeves short or long as you want. Now let's get to our sewing machine. First of all, it is important to finish the neckline. That makes the work easy. So I cut the lining from the petticoat, same as the collar. See, one important tip I share with you here. Most of the saris, they have beads, stones, stonework, embroideries, or such things where the needle doesn't go smoothly on embroidery and stonework. So how you can manage this? One is go very slow on those kind of embroideries and stoneworks, because your needle will not be able to stitch on hard stones and embroidery. But if it is plastic work, then your machine will run smoothly. Once your collar is done, turn it and press it from the back side. This collar is slightly smaller than the neckline. So here in the middle of the collar, we make a small cut and a small cut on the back of the neckline. Join both these cuts and just see how to place the collar on the sari neckline only, because this inside lining you have to take it out. And now starting from the middle, stitch on this collar, join this collar with the neckline. See, if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the below comment section. I try to make the videos very elaborate. I try to explain each and every part, because when I was a kid, I wanted to learn. There were not many people who could teach me or who could show me. So I want to help as many people as I can. That's why I want to explain in detail. But if you want the videos to be short, please let me know. So here we join the collar, and same way we will join the collar from the other side. Here we keep the lining on the collar. Like we have three layers. One is net sari neckline, okay? One is this petticoat lining, and the third layering is that of collar. And then we make a stitch. I made a small cut, like about 2 inches. So here we can simply fold this cut and turn it. After stitching, we can turn the lining for that beautiful V type neck in the front. Once you stitch the neckline, because this is important, turn the lining and your neckline will look this way. The collar will be joined like this. Make a top stitch on the joint that will make the stitches and the collar stay on its place. See, I'm not very good in English, but I try my best that I explain things clearly to you. Still, if you feel there is something that you want better, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much. So here we make a top stitch. And one last thing, this is the border, the white thing. So here we keep it, pin it, and then make stitch over it. So this method is good when you want a small opening for your neckline. But if you want a zipper in the front, then I will show the entire method at the end of this video. So these are two methods that I'm showing you. So I set the machine on zigzag and run on this border. That will make the stitches very beautiful and make the work faster. So I've explained everything about Usha Stitch Magic, Usha Genome Stitch Magic on this channel. You can either ask me or check out the videos here. That may be of value to you, that would be helpful to learn this machine. So here we finished it. Our front is, it is, this dress is very easy, you know. When you have to go to a party and you don't have any dress, this is very easy. Now we attach the sleeves. Sleeves are simple. We just keep it. The curvy side will be joined in the front and the back side to the back this way. And everything I shared here in this video, all these videos I explained earlier, step by step, each and every step. So here we join, and now we join the skirt. So this is important, you need to see this. So first of all, join the bodies from the sides, starting from the sleeve till the waist, join from both sides and then turn it and press it a little. Now close the side of the skirt. See, I'm not taking the entire sari. I'm taking barely 2 meter fabric from the sari here. So in all, I took less than 3 meter fabric from the sari to make this dress. Next step is to fold the petticoat waist to fit it with the waist round of the bodies. So make small pleats, gathers like this. So you could adjust the width of the petticoat with the body's waist width this way, and fold the sari on this petticoat this way, or make a kachcha or place like this. Then you need to join them. How you do it? Turn the petticoat, the lining you can see, and insert the bodies the right side out. Adjust it. Here we had two belt that I stitched from sides, folded and turned. Then we keep the loose ends of the belt on the side of the skirt and join the bodies, the belt and the skirt. Make sure the pleats fall in place, and here your dress is ready. Now I give you one bonus tip. This is to add the zipper. Here you completed your dress, but if you feel, or in any of the dresses, you want one zipper to be added, this is one simple method. Cut your dress from the middle, and this cut should be 1 inch less than the zipper. Use the zigzag stitch, because that can fasten the dress with the fabric with the zipper very nicely. I'm using the zipper foot and zigzag stitch. I shared this all the details, all the tips and hacks in earlier video. If you want that, please let me know, I'll share it again. So here, turn it. You can keep the needle inside and turn it. And then again the zigzag stitch on the other side too. It is just like a simple zipper stitching. So here you complete it, and this way, this dress really came out so easy, so beautiful, and I never imagined a sari that I didn't wear for last 6 years, I feel like wearing every day. It's so beautiful. I'm sure you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe to this channel. Please support, and thank you so much for watching. Take very good care of yourself. Bye-bye.